Merry Christmas, everybody. My name is Scott Morganroth, Motor City Madmouth, and joining me on this special day is Rick Curti, Mr. Opinion. Rick, glad to have you on this incredible holiday.
Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
All right, well, folks, today's theme and episode is called Let's Go Bowlings, where we actually go ahead and touch on five of the most intriguing bowl games slash names. So we're going to do this in rapid fire. I found some really interesting ones out there. And we'll begin with the Idaho Potato Bowl, which was held on December 21st, 2021 on the Bluefield out in Boise State. And that featured the Wyoming Cowboys, who happened to win this contest 52-38 over Kent State. Rick, some observations on the Idaho Potato Bowl.
Well, I love it. I love potatoes. I loved at the end that they dumped French fries over the head coach instead of Gatorade. Very intriguing. You got to love the Smurf turf. I love the Smurf turf, one of the best fields in all of football with the blue AstroTurf. Great game, very competitive, and I'm a huge fan of it.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm always into big, interesting things. And when you talk about a potato bowl, folks, I know we're probably making you hungry later on. We don't know what you have on your Christmas dish, but a potato bowl to me is pretty cool stuff, especially in a state which is known for that particular food.
Yeah, anything that's named after food and with sports, I love it. And I love potatoes. I love baked potatoes. I love French fries. And it's a great name. It's a great bowl. It was a great game. And you have it on the Smurf turf. What more can you ask for?
Well, it's appropriate. Idaho potatoes, bowl, okay, I can handle that. Let's stay on the food theme for a moment. And a lot of Green Bay Packers fans are probably very well aware of what I'm about to say. They call it the Cheez-It Bowl. They may not be aware of the fact that, you know, Cheez-It doesn't really apply to Lambeau, but the Cheez-It Bowl is going to actually be held on December 29th, my birthday, by the way, in Orlando, featuring Iowa State against Clemson. So, you know, I guess it's interesting how Clemson wears orange jerseys, okay, and we have cheese if you're a cheddar cheese guy. Folks, am I making you hungry? Okay, we have that Cheez-It Bowl. I see them in the grocery stores all the time. So, Rick, I don't know. Do you eat Cheez-Its, first of all?
I do like Cheez-Its. And again, anything that's mentioned with food in it, I love it. So baked potato, Cheez-Its, I'm getting hungry. I love it. And I just don't think that's a coincidence that they put Clemson in orange with the Cheez-It Bowl that's in orange. So I think that's kind of cool marketing right there for them.
It's all about marketing, Rick. And I think anytime you talk about cheese, it is synonymous with the Green Bay Packers, but the Cheez-It, you know, it's always been one of my favorite snacks, and there's no better place than to have it up in Orlando, where when you go to Orlando, you go there for a couple things. Number one, okay, you go to the Disney and all the tourist attractions, and number two, you eat a lot. And I got news for you. If you've been to the Church Street Station up in Orlando, a lot of great food places there. I guess it's safe to say that what they'll be serving over up in Orlando, the Cheez-It Bowl. So I think it's pretty cool. I like the idea. And again, we'll stay with the food theme there. Pretty much.
Yeah, I love the Cheez-It Bowl, and hope it continues. And it's kind of cool to see Clemson. I'm not too far from Clemson, South Carolina. So it's going to be an intriguing game. So we'll see what happens.
All right, well, we're going to get off the food situation for a moment. And we're going back to Los Angeles. And I know we talked about this on the Sports Exchange one time, but we're going to kick it around a little bit today, called the Jimmy Kimmel Bowl that was out in LA, held on December 18th. Utah State defeated Oregon State 24-13. Jeez, oh, please, you get a celebrity's name on top of a bowl game, that doesn't catch your attention, then I don't know what does.
Yeah, when I first heard of it, I thought it was a joke. I just thought the Jimmy Kimmel Bowl, really? Oh, okay, whatever. And then I found out, no, it really is a bowl. So it's in my home city of Los Angeles, where I grew up. You got celebrities, Hollywood, football. I mean, it's all about, you know, marketing. It's all about location, location, location. And good for Jimmy Kimmel to have a bowl. He's got a successful show. Why not have a bowl?
Yeah, well, you know, it's appropriate. I guess the one word that we use throughout our show here today is the word appropriate. And Jimmy Kimmel Bowl in LA makes a whole lot of sense. And yeah, more power to Jimmy. If you get your name out on a bowl game, you're certainly going to get national attention. He's been on shows. Why not? I think it's, I really like it. I think it's really very, very appropriate, and I have zero problem with it at all. Now, one bowl that I would actually put on a bucket list, believe it or not, would be called the Bahamas Bowl that was held on December 17th out in Paradise. So, you know, in this contest, you have Middle Tennessee winning 31-24 over the Toledo Rockets. So it's safe to say those kids there up in Ohio and Tennessee could at least have a good time in the Bahamas. But I would put it on a bucket list, despite the fact that they're, you have a lot of empty seats. So I don't know, Rick, would you ever be intrigued to go to the Bahamas Bowl?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, who wouldn't want to go to the Bahamas and you get to play football? You know, UNCC made their first bowl a couple of years ago, and it was the Bahamas Bowl. And they were very excited to be there. They loved it. I think it's great. Like I said, it's all about location, location, location. And why not have a college football game in the Bahamas? I mean, it's a vacation, sporting event. It's fantastic. Why not?
It only makes you wonder if they could ever build this bowl to where you think it could be, whether they can put a whole lot more people in the stands. But I don't know, folks, Bahamas Bowl or not, I would actually consider putting that on a bucket list. With that said, let's stay with the bucket list thing for a moment, and we'll talk about the Music City Bowl, which will be held on December 30th out in Nissan Stadium, the home of the Tennessee Titans. Intriguing matchup there, Purdue of the Big Ten against the Tennessee Volunteers, who, by the way, wear orange, who, by the way, don't have to go very far to travel to get to Nashville from Knoxville. So, I don't know, Music City Bowl, who the heck wouldn't want to go out there and party in Nashville, Tennessee, arguably one of the greatest cities in the country during the holiday season? My goodness, this is a natural if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great bowl. Nashville is a great city, a lot like Charlotte. I almost moved there many years ago. I thought about it and I came to Charlotte. Nashville is a great city. You got music, country music. Tennessee is pretty much a home game for them because it's not that far. I mean, like the Bahamas, who would want to go to Nashville? It's a great party scene, very lively entertainment, and they love the college football in Tennessee, so it's great.
Yeah, I mean, my goodness, I've been to Nashville lots of times, visited family there, and, you know, I've always wanted to go to that bowl game. It just, circumstances never worked out to cover it, but whether I get to it or not, at least I know as long as I have family there, I would certainly make an attempt to go, and even if I don't have family there, it would be something intriguing to do. But yeah, I think you talk about one of the most no-brain bowls. If you can get to it and you have an opportunity, then by all means, let's go to the Music City Bowl. One bowl that unfortunately I'm a little bit disgusted with right now was a Hawaii Bowl. And that's when the Hawaii Rain Bowls pulled out because of COVID-19. And that bowl's been canceled the last 2 years because of COVID and circumstances. But, you know, unfortunately, University of Memphis or Memphis State, the Tigers got hosed because they actually had to take that trip across to Hawaii. Now, I don't know what the payout situation, whether they'll get reimbursed for their expenses or whatnot. But, you know, to me, you would think Hawaii Bowl would be on a bucket list because, again, you're talking about another bowl in paradise, another warm weather climate. And if you've ever been to Hawaii before, it's certainly an unbelievable place. And I've really enjoyed my times going there. But this is unfortunate that the Memphis football program got hosed and that Hawaii, which they create the bowl for the Warriors anyways, but this was not a very good ending, Rick.
Yeah, I agree. They really got the short end of the stick. It's unfortunate. It's unfortunate that teams have, like Texas A&M couldn't be in the bowl game because of this new variant going around. And it's just, I just feel my heart goes out to Memphis. Hopefully next year there'll be brighter things for them, but it's just unfortunate what happened to them.
Now, I know there's a lot of other bowls I'm not going to get to because I really wanted to target in on the 5+1 because of the Hawaii situation. But there's no doubt that when you have 42+ bowl games, you're going to see an awful lot of empty seats, which is a shame, but obviously they do it anyways. It's popular. It's good for recruiting. But more importantly, okay, the one thing I do like about the bowl games is the NFL scouts have plenty of opportunity to find future talent for other teams. So, Rick, as you put things in perspective about the bowl games, give me some closing thoughts.
Well, I love the bowl games. I know a lot of people make fun of them, say, hey, there's too many bowl games going around. But it's also good, you know, for smaller schools to get noticed. People are always looking for those hidden gems. You don't know if there could be another Kurt Warner, a Tom Brady out there, somebody that was just like maybe not looked at upon. And, you know, now with social media going around, you could be in a, I mean, you could be in a big university or you can be in a small university. It doesn't matter. People are always looking for that hidden gem. And, you know, we always find somebody out there that no one ever talks about, never gets that publicity. And they're huge stars. I think of Rob Gronkowski right away that nobody really paid attention to. And now he's a huge personality and a star. So I love them. I think they're great. And I love all these whimsical bowl games. They're fun.
Yeah, well, they're certainly fun to talk about, which has prompted us, our idea to come up in the first place. For y'all, you folks that are wondering why I'm wearing a Michigan Wolverines hat, it's safe to say, you know, who I'm pulling for on December 31st at the Orange Bowl when the Wolverines take on the Georgia Bulldogs. Just make mention of it. That's why I'm wearing the hat. But yeah, without a doubt, Rick, I mean, it's an opportunity to find future talent, a good way to give the students a trip. You know, I know they've had to go to the 5-7 situation to get Rutgers over against Wake Forest. We're not going to get into that, but over in the Gator Bowl. But yeah, it's a great opportunity for kids to end the year scouting. And it's unfortunate you have so many or so many empty stadiums. But folks, we encourage your feedback if there's any other bowls that we've gone out there and left off. But these are the ones that for sure stood out. So, all right, Rick, with that said, why don't you let everybody know how they can get a hold of you? Yeah.
You can contact me on my website at www.charlottebats.com. My email address is cltbatsbaseball@gmail.com. I'm also on Facebook at Charlotte MLB and Charlotte Bats. I'm also on Instagram at Charlotte Bats and on Twitter at Charlotte Bats Baseball. And I'm also on the LinkedIn under Rick Curti.
And of course, he's a prominent broadcaster here at the South Florida Tribune. We appreciate everything he does on social media and then some. And in terms of contact information for us, you can reach us at southfloridatribune@gmail.com. You can find these broadcasts on www.southfloridatribune.com. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Certainly looking to get as many subscribers as we can. And if you have any suggestions for ideas, feel free to let us know. And finally, you can locate us on Twitter at Tribune South. So on behalf of Rick Curti, Mr. Opinion, my name is Scott Morganroth, the Motor City Madmouth, wishing you a very, very Merry Christmas. And until the next time, we, Rick and I, will have plenty of more good stuff to talk about. Take care, everybody, and thanks for joining us.
Merry Christmas.